Hey everybody, and welcome back to another Redstone video. As you already saw, for today I created a slot machine. It has a ton of unique features and is very compact for what it does. Before I show you how to build it though, let's first go over some of the functionalities which make this slot machine so special. As you already saw, you win by getting three of the same type of block in a row. However, the machine can actually differentiate between getting three diamond blocks in a row and getting three gold or emerald blocks in a row. This allowed me to implement a jackpot system. You can fully configure the prices via these lecterns right here. At the moment, the normal price is set to 7 diamonds and the jackpot price is set to 10 diamonds. Meaning that if I now get 3 gold blocks or 3 emerald blocks in a row, I should get 7 diamonds. I can quickly add a little circuit to trick the system into thinking that I won. Okay, so let me just simulate getting a normal win. As you can see, I got 7 diamonds right there. And if I now win a jackpot, I just won 10 more. Now I can configure this however I want. I personally like having 5 diamonds as the lower price and 12 diamonds as the higher price, but you can, as I just said, set this to whatever you want. Another feature I would like to show you is automatic mode. As long as you have this lever right here flicked, it will automatically begin a new round after the previous one has ended. It will only stop doing that when you unflick this lever or when you run out of diamonds. Another advantage of this slot machine is that all of the diamonds inserted by the user will gradually end up in this dropper right here, which is also the prize pool, and that basically means that you never ever have to refill it. However, there are some other items which you have to refill, which is kelp or any of these items right here. You don't necessarily have to use kelp. Let me show you why. It's because this casino actually runs on a very special randomizer, which I came up with myself. You just click this button, or it gets activated by the diamond which is inserted. And over time, it will randomly activate these three lamps in this example, or stop the spinning wheels. For that to happen though, this composter needs to fill up, and kelp. When you pour kelp into a composter, it basically has a 30% chance of growing by a layer. And we can use that to also lengthen the redstone signal to reach all of these areas right here. So that's why you need to restock kelp. Or as I just said, any of these other items. However, you don't really have to do it manually. You can also add some hoppers to this line right here and just add some more chests or like a bulk storage system or just a farm actually, which just runs kelp or the other items into this chest right there. Still, one chest should last you about 150 games, so it should in theory also be enough if you just come here at some time and refill this chest. If you want to check this slot machine out before building it for yourself, there are links to this world and also a schematic in the video description. Videos like this one take me days, sometimes even weeks to create. So if you like what you see and you want to support my channel, please consider leaving a like and subscribing. Thanks. Also, if you come across any problems while building this thing, you can always join my Discord server if you want to hang out, or if you have any questions. A link to that one can also be found in the video description. But now, let's get building. This is the foundation for the tutorial. Just a basic wall with some cutouts for the different slots. Okay, let's get this started. First, punch out some of these blocks, like shown. Place some slabs in these positions. A redstone lamp with a button on top. Now drop down here and place a transparent object. I'm using glass in this case. Place a redstone dust on top. A piston to the side of it with an observer at its face. Come out two blocks and place a repeater on 3 ticks delay. Another observer running into another piston with a redstone block in this position right here. Now you want to place a shape like shown. With a comparator right here, some redstone dust, a repeater on 1 tick, a redstone torch and some more redstone. Now you can already place 2 upwards facing droppers, like so. And also the hoppers. You want to make sure that one is facing into the comparator, like so, and the other one is facing into this lower dropper. Now let's set up the item filter. You want to take 23 diamonds and split them up like this. As you can see, one of them drops down into the lower hopper. And yeah, now we can just place in our shulker box. And the item filtering system should be complete. We can just quickly test it out. Take a few diamonds, place them in there, hit the button, and only one of them should get taken out. Next up, you want to come back to this block right here and add a barrel like so, with a hopper running into it, a composter on top, another hopper pointing into the composter, and another double chest on top. Now take a redstone comparator output from this composter, run it into a block, like so, and add some more blocks. Remember to use a transparent block in this case, and just follow this shape. Now add some redstone dust, and 3 redstone repeaters, all on 1 tick. Take some more hoppers and point them into this one like so. And now come to this chest and fill it with any of these items. I'm personally gonna use kelp for this tutorial, as it's pretty easy to set up a farm for that. As you can see, now this composter is filling up and gradually extending the signal up to this repeater right here. Now you want to come to this area right here and place a few more blocks in this kind of position, with repeaters going into them and a bit of redstone dust. Now come here and place a few more blocks like so. With some more repeaters on 1 tick and some redstone dust. Take a few node blocks and place them like this, with observers coming out of them, going into another block. Now take some observers and point them like this from this right node block, going into another node block, with an observer in this direction, and now add observers facing away from these repeaters like so. Then you want to come back to this node block and place a stone button, or any button, below it, so that it redirects this redstone signal right here. Okay, now you want to come here and take some more observers and place them like this, facing upwards. Take some more and put them like this, with some redstone blocks in these holes right here, some more observers, going into blocks, and now take a bit of redstone dust and place it like so on top of the observer and node block. Now you can already take some of your pistons and add them into these gaps right here, some more into these gaps, and also over here. Now you want to place blocks like this, with redstone dust on top, an observer, going into another block, with redstone dust on top, with another observer, going once again into a block with redstone dust on top. Now add some pistons, like so, and also a few observers, going into node blocks, now hit this node block 6 times, this one 10 times, and this one 13 times. And once again this one 10 times. Okay, now take some more pistons and place them like this. And a few more like this, below these node blocks. Now come here and place some pistons in these positions, with observers coming out of these node blocks into these pistons. Now place some more blocks in these positions right here, with some repeaters on top, and set these last ones to 4 ticks delay. Once again, place some blocks at the side of these observers and add repeaters and set the last one to 4 ticks of delay. Come down here and place a shape like this with a block of emeralds and a node block on top. Add some redstone dust, 2 repeaters on 1 tick, a sticky piston with an observer which is facing upwards. Add some more blocks, and then a transparent block right here, and just add 3 pieces of redstone dust. Now let's add the actual spinning wheels for this slot machine. So just stand on this piston, and place a block of gold, a block of emerald, and a block of diamond, then a block of diamond, emerald, and gold. Just repeat this 2 more times. Like so, so that you have this pattern right here. And then come to the back and place a block right there, 4 transparent blocks on top, like so. And then at the very top, fill these gaps with another full block. Come to this side of the slot machine and place a few blocks like so. Add redstone dust on top and place some node blocks in these positions. Now just add some sticky pistons and build a shape like this. Add some comparators on top of all of these blocks, and now you can add your lecterns right here and right here. Now what you have to do is write a book. You want this to have 15 pages, and on the first page you want to write 2 diamonds, on the second page 3 diamonds, on the third page 4 diamonds, and so on. Just continue this until you reach page 15 and 16 diamonds. This book, once again, has to have exactly 15 pages, otherwise it's not gonna work. Now just add this book to both of these lecterns And now you can already select how much you want the customer to win. So if the customer gets 3 diamonds in a row, I want him to win, in this example, 12 diamonds. So I'll just select 12 in this upper bookshelf, excuse me, lectern. And if the customer gets 3 emerald blocks or gold blocks in a row, I want him to win 5 diamonds. Come here and place a node block in this position with a block of gold below it, and click the node block 10 times. Now come back here and place a shape like this, with comparators here and here, and some redstone dust. Now add an observer facing into the lower dropper, 2 more observers, and another one right here. Add some redstone dust on top, place a block, and another node block next to it with another block of gold below it. And now click this one 6 times. For the casino's automatic mode, just come down here and place a repeater on 4 ticks, going into a sticky piston with an observer. Now just add 2 repeaters, both on 4 ticks again. Then you can place your lever with a block and a piece of redstone dust behind it. Place your node block and another sticky piston with a block at its front. And that should be the entire casino constructed. Now let's check if this slot machine actually works. First off, just put some diamonds into this upper dropper. Over time, it will get filled automatically by all of the user's diamonds. Now just stand here. As you can see, I have nothing in this shulker box, and also nothing happens. If I put any other item in, nothing happens. Only if I put in my diamonds, it will actually activate the machine. Looks like I didn't get lucky there, so let's just activate automatic mode, and I'll show you a bit of a time lapse until I get to win. Okay, looks like I finally won some diamonds. As you can see, I just won 5 diamonds, just like I set it up. Seems like I finally got the jackpot. Only took me a lot of diamonds, but hey. As you can see, it automatically put the diamonds I inserted into this dropper, and also it used up about 17 stacks of kelp, which is okay, but like, if you don't want to constantly refill this chest, you can always add more storage using this hopper, or just directly add a farm to it. So yeah, that's it for this video for today. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye!